Today we will discuss tuned amplifier, that is the fourth unit of the subject analog electronics. So let's discuss first what is tuned amplifier. So as you can see, there are two figures, figure 1 and figure 2, and you are familiar with this frequency response. We have seen this kind of frequency response in our previous means third unit, a high frequency amplifier, where we have seen this kind of frequency response means at low frequency the gain is low, means fall, and at some range of frequency the gain is constant, and again the gain falls at higher frequency. So here this kind of frequency response shows the band pass response, where the bandwidth is this much. So here you can see this flat portion where the gain is constant for this range of frequency. If somehow by doing some circuit change, or we can say by making some change in the circuit, if we are able to get this kind of response where the maximum gain is only at one frequency, that is called the corner frequency. So if you can say the gain peaks around a particular frequency called center frequency, but it is not the case here. Here the maximum gain is for this range of frequency, but here the maximum gain is centered at particular frequency, that is called center frequency. If this kind of frequency response we are getting, or somehow we are managed by adjusting the circuit arrangement, then we called it that amplifier as a tuned amplifier. So that's tuned. It is said tuned because it is the maximum gain is tuned at some particular frequency, fc, that is called center frequency, or you can say tuned frequency. So basically this kind of amplifier is used in the radio and TV receivers, and this tuned frequency, or you can say the center frequency of a tuned amplifier, can be adjusted to coincide with the frequency of a desired channel, so that the signals of that particular channel can be received and signals other than channels are attenuated or filtered out. So in circuit, by adjusting the component, we will discuss what kind of component. Basically there is a LC tuned LC circuit. From there we can tune this frequency. So by adjusting this frequency, we can match whatever the station frequency is. Suppose the station frequency is, for example, our FM frequency are in the range of megahertz. So if we tune this frequency to particular station, that can be catch or we can say received, and the signals, other signals are attenuated, which are not desired. So basically the purpose of tuned amplifier is to tune a circuit to a particular frequency, so that we can match our circuit frequency with the station frequency. Okay, so basically there is a tuning between station frequency and our LC circuit, this tuned amplifier frequency. and these are basically used in receivers, radio receivers, TV receivers. Basically it's a first stage in super heterodyne receivers. Okay, so there are some features of tuned amplifier. So tuned amplifier are also called RF amplifier or narrow band amplifier. So the what because this generates RF frequency signals and the bandwidth is low for this kind of amplifier, the smaller band is mainly due to larger gain and very high quality factor. The frequency range of this kind of amplifier are this. It is a non-linear amplifier and operates on a principle of parallel resonance. In a tuned amplifier, one particular signal frequency, or you can say one particular band of signal frequency, can be transmitted while other signal frequencies are rejected, and the general resonant frequency of tuned amplifier is 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. That we will see in coming slides. So, and it is the first stage in super heterodyne receiver. It has very high selectivity. So, it has very high selectivity. Front end selectivity of the receiver is done by RF amplifier. And selectivity is nothing but it is defined as the ability of the receiver to reject unwanted signal frequency. So basically it selects particular frequency and rejects all others, which is not useful. So that's why it is called it, the selectivity is very high, and it's have also very high quality factor. Next is, let's discuss the type of tuned amplifier. So there it has three types of tuned amplifier: single tuned amplifier, double tuned amplifier, staggered tuned amplifier. In all three cases, there is some difference with respect to circuit and the bandwidth. So we will discuss one by one. So let's discuss first single tuned amplifier. So this is the circuit arrangement of single tuned amplifier, where there is a one LC circuit is connected at the collector and supply. So basically this part of the amplifier is works as a tuned amplifier. Means this part is used for tuning to a particular frequency, that is called center frequency, or you can say the tuning frequency. So this is the frequency response of this single tuned amplifier. So at we can tune this amplifier at a frequency 1 upon 2 pi under root LC by adjusting this capacitor. So by adjusting this capacitor, we can tune this frequency to a particular station, whatever we want to, at whatever frequency we want to tune. So basically this is a variable capacitor. So here we can use a varactor diode. The varactor diode can be used for this purpose, to change the capacitance of this LC tuned circuit. So basically varactor capacitor, varactor diode is a nothing but a variable capacitor, where we can get the variable capacitor by varying the voltage across the diode. So I hope you have studied varactor diode in your third semester electronic device subject. So this capacitor can be varied, and accordingly this resonant frequency can be adjusted to desired station frequency. So here f naught, and these are the cutoff frequencies, of course, from 1 upon root 2 times of the maximum is defined as a cutoff frequency, or you can say the minus 3 dB from the peak value. So this is the bandwidth, and that can be calculated by this equation. The lower cutoff frequency is nothing but f naught minus delta, means that this bandwidth divided by 2, and fh will be this f naught plus this portion. This portion is nothing but bandwidth upon 2. So this fl will be f naught minus bandwidth upon 2, and fh will be f naught plus bandwidth upon 2. And also bandwidth can also be adjusted, or we can say altered, by varying either f naught and q. But there is a limitation of altering f naught, because if we alter f naught, the station frequency may get changed. So we will vary. So to change or to increase the bandwidth, we have to change the quality factor, not f naught, because f naught changes the station frequency. So we have to change the quality factor of this tuned circuit, or you can say the inductor, and we can change the frequency. So bandwidth is decreases if we increase the quality factor. So bandwidth can be altered by varying q, not by varying f naught, because if we altered f naught, station gets changed. So if we want to increase bandwidth, we have to decrease quality factor. Okay, so since the quality factor is high, so the bandwidth is small. So that is the one of the disadvantages of single tuned amplifier. It's have smaller bandwidth. Okay, so and one more important thing in case of single tuned amplifier is it has the constant gain bandwidth product. The gain and bandwidth is constant. So if bandwidth is decreased, the gain is increases. Gain decrease, bandwidth increases. So ultimately in single tuned amplifier, the gain bandwidth product is always constant, and the disadvantage is it's have smaller bandwidth. So and to improve the bandwidth issue in this single tuned amplifier, another two types of tuned amplifier are there, that is double tuned amplifier and staggered tuned amplifier, that we will discuss later. Now let's discuss analyze this single tuned amplifier, and we will calculate the oscillation frequency and the gain and bandwidth of this amplifier. So let's perform the analysis of this amplifier. So you can see this is the AC equivalent circuit of the amplifier. I didn't consider the biasing resistor. For simplicity, I just taken the input at this transistor, and then AC equivalent circuit I have considered C, L, and I have also considered one load resistor RL. Okay, so ultimately at the output side RL, this is R, not RL, because I have combined R naught, that is the internal output impedance of the transistor, and RL. So R is nothing but the parallel combination of R naught and RL. I hope you understood. If there is one RL and there is one R naught because of the equivalent model of this VZT. So R is nothing but the R naught parallel RL, and this is C and this is L of the tuned circuit, and this is the equivalent model of transistor only. So this input is, and this is current GMVI. So this transistor may be FET or BZT, whatever, and depending upon the circuit, what kind of circuit is, whether it is by using FET or BZT. Okay, so now let's calculate the transfer function of this amplifier. So for the simplicity, I just neglect the effect of biasing resistor, this biasing resistor R1, R2, and the effect of RS. And that can also be considered, but here for the simplicity, I just neglect it. So let's calculate the transfer function of this AC equivalent circuit. Let's calculate V naught. So our ultimate aim is to calculate V naught upon VI. So let's calculate V naught. So V naught is nothing but this current and the total impedance. Total impedance is ZL, that is the parallel combination of R, C and L. So the output voltage will be this current GMVI minus, because we are calculating V naught plus minus like this, and the current direction is opposite, that's why this negative sign is minus GMVI upon YL. So V naught is current multiplied by ZL, or you can say the current divided by admittance, impedance, or divided by multiplied by impedance or divided by admittance. So ultimately this equation, finally V naught upon VI is this much. If we adjust this VI taken coming the denominator of this, so ultimately we will get this equation. So this equation is a, if we compare this equation with the general form of second order bandpass function, that is something kind of PS upon S square plus AS plus B. If we compare to that standard equation of second order bandpass, I hope you have studied in your network subject or in somewhere in filter, the general form of different filters like high pass, band pass, band reject. So PS upon S square plus AS plus B is a general form of band pass. PS square upon S square plus AS plus B is a high pass something. So and PS square plus Q upon S square plus AS plus B, something kind of, is for band reject. So this is the band pass function. So if we compare this portion, that is the constant associated with the S is our bandwidth of the band pass filter, and this constant term is our center frequency. So 1 upon LC is our center frequency, this term, and 1 upon CR is our bandwidth. So in general form, this constant relates bandwidth and this constant relates center frequency. So ultimately quality factor is omega naught upon B, that will be equal to omega naught CR. And then we can calculate the gain at center frequency, means we are talking about this gain, or you can say the maximum gain, the gain at the center frequency F naught, or you can say J omega naught. So if you put s is equal to j omega naught in this equation, we will get minus gm into r. So ultimately the magnitude of center frequency or the gain at center frequency will be gm into r. Now let's discuss a numerical based on the same concept. It is required to design a tuned amplifier of the type shown in figure. That means we are talking about this one. So figure having F naught, that means tuned frequency 1 MHz, 3 dB bandwidth, 10 kHz center frequency is given, FET available has a bias point, GM is given, R naught is given, the output capacitance is negligibly small, determine the value of RL, CL and L. Okay, so question is asking this, the RL, so this is R, that is R naught parallel RL. So from that we have to calculate RL, this C and this L. So as we know, the center frequency gain is equal to minus 10, it is given this, and that is equal to minus GM R. We just seen here the gain at center frequency is minus GMR. So the center frequency gain, that is 10, will be equal to minus GM into R. So from this R is equal to 2 kilo ohm, GM is equal to 5 milliampere per volt. Okay, so R is 2 kilo ohm, and since R is equal to RL parallel R naught, and R naught is given, and R we have already calculated, we can find the RL. And from the bandwidth equation, D is equal to 1 upon CR, we can find C, because bandwidth is given, this 10 kHz, and R is already calculated, so we can calculate C this much. And then from bandwidth equation, where omega naught is equal to 1 upon under root LC, you can find the L. Omega naught is given, C we have already calculated, from here we can calculate L. So it is about single tuned amplifier. In our next video we will discuss double tuned amplifier and staggered tuned amplifier. That will overcome the issue, or you can say the disadvantage of single tuned amplifier. Thank you.